I consider myself to be sort of a sponge. You know, anything that I look at or read or listen to really comes out in a way that's obvious to me but no one else can see. I started painting in 2004, on the 10th of February 2004, which was my first day of TAFE. Because before that I was a performer and running around juggling and doing dangerous stuff, and my finale involved getting a milk crate and then 3 20-litre plastic buckets and balancing on that and juggling sharp things and then stuffing around and pretending to fall off at the end. And if you do that every day for years, sooner or later your body just goes, nah. So I sort of had a fracture in my shin, like I could hardly really walk much. I decided I needed to still eat food, so I got on the dole, and that sucks. Don't ever get on the dole. So I was like, can I do anything else other than this? And like, oh, you can study. The only thing I could get into at the last minute was art, because they don't care, because they'll take 40 people knowing that within a month there'll be 10. So I just bluffed my way in and thought I'd sit up the back with the dumb kids and, you know, make a mess and chat up arty girls. And it came to me really easily. I was really surprised, actually. It's the first thing I've ever been naturally good at. With painting, it was kind of like, oh, I don't know what I'm doing, I can't do it. And then, oh, wow, that was easy. So I'd lost all interest in anything except painting pretty much at that point, became very obsessive. I kind of faded into doing markets and starting to sell stuff, and then it just built from there. I started to gain galleries and win prizes, and it's just been this big growing machine. You know, every little bit builds on the next bit. The thing that I have that most artists don't have is I share a studio with another artist, and it makes it a lot more fun. Me and Karen really bounce off each other a lot. She's kind of my polar opposite as an artist in a lot of ways, because my stuff's all about planning and very carefully constructing it, and Karen's stuff is all about emotional spontaneity. She just, you know, works better when she doesn't plan it.
I started painting when I met David. I'd always been told in art school that you can't paint. You know, my teacher wasn't very encouraging, and he said, oh, you're a much better drawer, you know. So I just kept drawing, and I've been travelling around Australia for 20 years just drawing everything, especially festivals and circuses. And then 10 years ago I meet this circus performer who says, here's some canvas, here's paint, doesn't matter how good you are or whatever, as long as you love it, as long as you have fun. So I had fun, and I haven't stopped having fun. And now we have the joy of painting next to each other, which is the best thing in the whole world.
Clay Island, everyone knows you, and I didn't realise this until just recently. It's really important for small communities like this to have champions.
I love Maclay. Just being able to look out at the water, go for walks by the water, look at beautiful mangroves, the community here, everybody's really friendly. Everybody looks out for each other. It's a very close community. And there's lots and lots of artists and writers and all sorts of creative people hidden away on the island.
In small communities like this, they try and make you out that you're more important and more successful than you really are. Like, the, you know, any slight hint of it, they get really, really engaged, and they really want you to do well, and they really feel like if you succeed, then they succeed vicariously through you. The way that I work is about correction. Like, it's wrong and you're correcting it and making it right. So all you look at is what's wrong with it. And eventually you get to the point where you go, oh, I can't do any better, and just abandon it. And then you put it in the cupboard and you start on the next one. I don't really consider myself a realist. For me, I'm sort of a minimalist. So I'm actually very influenced by abstract art. I really like it because it's pure colour and pure tone. There's no form to hide behind. It is definitely easier when you have a form to hide behind, because people will look at what it is, so they don't focus as much on the colour or the mood. So I really try and have this abstract painting hidden behind the, you know, realist painting.
I'd have to say one of my most favourite pieces was when he did the Duchess, because just the energy and the light coming through the painting, didn't matter so much who the person was, but he seemed to capture the spirit. I'm probably his biggest fan. I watch him from the very beginning to the end, and it's a journey that we both go through.
My opinion of my own work. I'm always amazed, actually, how distinctive it looks, because I just do it the only way that I can. I'm not as good as I want to be. People are forcing me to be more fussy with my copyright, but I just am not, because I don't feel like I've done anything good yet. But for me, it's just, to answer the question, what I think of my work, it's the only way that I can work, you know? It's like writing in your handwriting. You can't write any other way, can't paint any other way. It doesn't matter what I think of it, I can't do anything else. So that's all there is to it. It's just me.